In today's Legendary Academy video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to play Simpsons Treehouse of Horror, the spiritual successor to the Simpsons arcade game from the 90s. This is a free-to-play, free-to-download, open-board-based game that is an absolute blast to play on your arcade cabinet.
Alright, so the first thing I want to do is download the file, of course. So you're going to want to visit this website, and I'll put a direct link in the video description box below. You're going to click on the download icon, and again, don't worry, this is not any kind of illegal activity. This is a free, open source, fan-made game, so it's completely free to download. Don't worry about any kind of legal ramifications, because it is meant to be free for everybody. So now that file is done, I'm going to drag that file folder onto the desktop, get rid of our Explorer there. I'm going to extract it. Does it rather quickly, opens up my file folder. And then this is the executable file that we will use to play the game. But first, let's go ahead and pull up our ArcadeNet link account. Go ahead and connect it. That way we can start streaming over to our cabinet. That's connected. Good. I'm going to double click our executable. It's going to open up the game. Now, while on the PC, I'm going to be using my keyboard just to get a few things set up real quick. So I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard. I'm going to use my arrow keys. I'm going to come down to the options and go to video options. Come down to here and I'm going to change the display mode to full. Back. Come down to control options.
And now on our arcade cabinet, we need to navigate to the BYOG menu, top menu here, and we should see an icon for our remote connection for our local streaming capability. So we're going to come down, select it with the A button. And we should see our control configuration menu where we left it from the PC. And sure enough, now let me fair warn you right out of the gate, the initial setup for the joysticks and the buttons to get this playable is really weird and finicky, and you got to jump over some hoops. However, you only have to do it once because it saves that configuration to a config file on your PC. So bear with me because we only have to do this once. But obviously this game was not meant and designed to run specifically for the AtGames Legends Ultimate Arcade cabinet, so it recognizes the control deck a little weird. So it thinks the player one side is over here where player two is traditionally, and right out of the gate it doesn't recognize the joystick for up and down and all that, so we have to tell it how to do that. What it does do is it recognizes the X and the A button over here on the player two side as up, down, and it recognizes the Z as your input or your enter command like you were using a keyboard. So we're going to use those to first kind of get everything tweaked and situated, and then we'll be able to use the joystick and the buttons from then on out. So we are on the default of setup player one, so I'm going to select it with my Z button, and now it brings me to my input commands. It's on the move up. So what I want to do is hit Z again. Allows me to begin to input my command. I'm going to hit up on the joystick. Now you see it recognizes it. Now I'm going to hit the X button to go down. Select it with Z. I'm going to input my command again. Down. And then left. And then right. For my attack buttons, you can configure this any way you want. I'm going to do A, B, and C. That's what I want as my attack buttons and everything. So I'm going to hit Z. Allows me to input my command. For attack one, I'm gonna hit A. Go down with the X button. Again, very finicky, but once you do this, it works completely intuitively once you initially set it up. So for the jump button, Z button, I'm gonna use my B. Block. I'm gonna hit the C button for my command. Go down again with the X button, Z. Now I start, I'm going to hit the player 2 start button, and then I'm going to come down, hit OK, select it with Z. Now player 1 is configured. We're going to have to do the same thing for player 2, because again, they're kind of crisscrossed. Come down with the X button, select it. Doing the same kind of thing, I hit our Z button to enter the command, hit up on our joystick. Come down, and we're just going to follow the same kind of process as we did previously, only we're doing it on the traditional player one side, even though it says player two. Again, it recognizes the game weird, but once you set it up, it plays perfectly fine. For my start button, I'm going to hit my start button up here, traditional player one side. hit OK. Now, you'll notice I can use my joystick, and I don't have to use the X and the A for my up and down, and I can go back to a traditional input command. So I'm using the player one side over here, and we're good to go. So I'm gonna hit back, and we're gonna start our game, finally. Again, once you get through that, that's all you have to do. You don't have to do it again. You can close out the game, you can come back 10 days later, play it, it'll save that configuration. Playable characters, we got Homer, we got Bartman, El Barto, whatever you want to call him, and we've got Krusty. Each one has unique attacks and everything, but we'll just start with my main man, Homer. But as you can see, using my joystick, punch button, jump button, block button, everything is working as we intended to and as we configured it with our button layouts. If we want the second player to jump in, there we go. Now we've got both players playing input commands, work exactly as we told them to, so we're good. So we got both players playing, and if you want four player action, that's completely possible. You'll just have to plug in some controllers into the USB ports of the control deck and go through that painstaking process with those controllers on your configuration, but it's absolutely completely doable to play four-player co-op on your @Games Legends Ultimate Arcade. And as you can see, it's got an expanded moveset, which really makes this game very fun to play. There's little side characters here that you can kind of unlock by smacking them around, and they kind of help you out throughout the level. So Grandpa Simpson now, he's gonna kind of go around crazy doing his weird chicken dance thing, and he's gonna be a distraction for me. So when I'm fighting all these aliens, pick up this power up, throw some donuts. I mean, it's loads of fun to play. Got a boss battle here. See if we get Milhouse to give us any help whatsoever. Nope. Apparently Milhouse is not gonna help. Disco Stew. There we go. Throw some pies. Big damage with these pies. Almost done. There we go. Kill some of these zombies. See if we can get Chief Wiggum to help us out. There we go. Thanks, Wiggum. And that does it for today's Legendary Academy video tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the content, and I hope you enjoy this game. It's an absolute blast to play, and again, if you need that direct download link, I'll have it in the video description box below. Go ahead and make sure you hit that like button, share this video with your friends if you found the information helpful. Until next time, class dismissed.